Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about semi-conservative DNA replication. To explain this, some knowledge is needed, especially in the cell cycle. Cell cycle is a life cycle of a cell. It consists of four phases. First of all, G1 phase, then S phase, then G2 phase, and finally the M phase, which is the mitosis phase. Mitosis is a mother cell division into two genetically identical daughter cells. But to be able to form these daughter cells and share the genetic material equally, the mother cell must first double its genetic material. This is called replication. Replication takes place during S phase. G1 phase, S phase, and G2 phase constitute the interphase. It is also important to know that one chromatid chromosome consists of one core DNA molecule. It is said that this DNA molecule is condensed. If we take a closer look at this DNA molecule, we can see a double helix, which has two coiled strands. Each strand contains nucleotide sequence with specific genetic information. Chromosomes may also have two chromatids, that is two DNA molecules bound together by a centromere. In order to get a two chromatids chromosome from a one chromatid chromosome, the DNA molecule must undergo semi-conservative replication. We start with a double-stranded DNA molecule, which is a one chromatid chromosome. Comes an enzyme called helicase, whose role is to separate the two strands of the DNA molecule. Once these two strands are separated, another enzyme will come, which is called DNA polymerase. Its role is to make a complementary strand to the parental strand. It will do this for each parental strand. Therefore, we get two double-stranded DNA molecules, which corresponds to a two chromatid chromosome. In order to be able to fairly share its genetic material during mitosis, the mother cell must first double its genetic material. This is called replication that takes place during the S phase. Thanks to two enzymes, helicase and DNA polymerase, the DNA molecule is split into two and two new complementary strands will be made. As one strand is kept, parental strand, and one strand is newly made, we call this reaction semi-conservative replication. Thanks for watching! I hope this video has given you a better understanding of semi-conservative DNA replication. Feel free to share this video and subscribe to my channel. See you next time!